There's a weird smell, right? Can you smell fried food? Is it you, Elliot?
For sure. Our guy's just eaten a triple serving of fries.
Well, I was just helping out with today's topic, SAF, Sustainable Aviation Fuel.
You've lost me here.
Basically, Sam, one way to decarbonize aviation will be to replace kerosene with aviation fuels that emit less CO2.
Right, but where do Elliot's fries come in?
Cooking oil!
That's right, Bess. You can make biofuel from cooking oil, as well as from other resources like agricultural or forestry waste.
Oh boy, so it'll compete with food crops?
No, that's not the idea. To be socially acceptable, biofuel cannot compete with food production and must be environmentally friendly.
No, but seriously, airplanes running on oil? It's gonna smell good up there.
You know, Sam, aircraft engines are already certified to operate with 50% sustainable fuel, some of which is made from cooking oil.
And soon, it'll be 100%!
That's right, Bess. It's actually already underway. Safran and partners have been regularly carrying out demo flights using 100% SAF since 2021. And as well as engines, Safran is developing fuel systems that are compatible with SAF.
But why don't we use SAF right away, then?
Well, airlines are using it more and more, but right now, SAF production is still pretty limited. There's still a lot of work to be done to make it accessible. Channels of production must be developed on a massive scale.
That's right. That's also why Safran is investing in startups to find alternative solutions like synthetic fuels.
Could someone oil the wheels for me and explain what synthetic fuels are?
In short, Sam, synthetic fuels are a combination of captured CO2 and hydrogen produced using low-carbon energy sources.
And like biofuel, synthetic fuels are actually compatible with today's airport infrastructure and airplane engines.
And in the future, airplanes will even be able to run on hydrogen!
Indeed! Hydrogen will either be used like a traditional fuel via combustion in a turbine, or it will supply a fuel cell to power electric propulsion. But there are a lot of challenges, because liquid hydrogen takes 4 times more volume than kerosene and has to be stored in a minus 253 degrees Celsius environment.
Which means adapting everything, transport, storage, tanks, everything.
Yes, we're looking at the long term here because it requires a huge technological breakthrough, but it's encouraging, and Safran and its partners are on it.
So with sustainable aviation fuels, we should be able to achieve carbon neutrality in 2050, right?
Mm-hmm. SAF will contribute half of the required effort, and the other half will come from reducing the aircraft's weight, its electrification, aerodynamics, ultra-efficient engines, etc.
For star French fries, a quarter mile from your location.
Oh, sorry. It's just that I'm starving. Do you fancy some fries? But decent fries, made properly, like double cooked.
No thanks. I'll pass this time.
Mmm, yummy.
Interesting.
Looks a bit greasy, don't you think?
Yes, but it gives you energy.